Hello children, this lesson is for class 10 physics and today our topic is moment of force. Now as I had earlier mentioned, I had sent you the pictures of the chapter, so I'm sure you have read a little, you've got a bit of idea, and today when I'm explaining it to you, you will get a better understanding of this topic. Now when I'm saying force, first, we will go a little backward and we will say what are the kinds of motion we had done in the earlier class. Now, the first is, let us say a car is moving in a straight line on the road, right? Now, what kind of motion is that? That is a translational motion, right? But suppose you are jogging around the park. You are jogging around the park. So then, what kind of a motion will it be? It will be a circular motion because you are going round and round the park. But suppose I take one more example. So what is that circular motion? So we have learned translational, that is in a straight line. Circular, that is moving in a round park. But here, you are not attached to the center of the park. Suppose a body is attached to the center. Let us say, for example, I'll take the case of this door. You can come a little closer. Okay. If I take this door, for example, and we see how this door moves. Yes, we know that can I pull the door outside? It will not go, right? But if I apply force, the force will move around the hinges. These are the hinges. So the hinges are vertically placed and the door is attached to the hinges. Okay, so it is moving around the hinges. This type of motion is called rotational motion. This is not circular, remember children. This is rotational motion. Alright, now same way if I draw the door on the board, right? I will see that these are the hinges on which the door is kind of fixed and the door moves in a manner like this. Okay, you can open and close the door by the application of force. Now suppose I apply the force over here. Okay, I apply the force near the hinges. What will happen? I still can open the door, but I have to apply a lot of force. I have to apply a huge magnitude of force. The work is very difficult. But the same work can be done with a very little force or with a very less magnitude of force once I apply the force at the handle, which is far away from the hinges. Right? So what we understand, therefore, moment of force. First, what do we understand by the moment of force? It is the turning effect of the force. That is, it is turning the door around a vertical axis or around an axis simply. So, moment of force means turning effect of force, turning the body around an axis. Right? Like for example, a steering wheel. The wheel is attached at this point and you are, you know, applying the force to turn the car this way and that way. So, steering wheel is also a very good example of the moment of force. It is also called torque. Okay, a similar example, you know, if you are pulling this screw, I don't have, with a kind of a, what do you say, a plier? You move it like this. So, that is also a kind of a moment of force. Or for example, you know, I take a lock and a key. Yes, I am turning the key around to open. And again, I can, you know, turn the key around the axis to close the lock. This can be a very good example of the moment of force. Alright? So, moment of force is basically about the rotational motion. We are not going to consider circular motion here. Rotational motion around the axis. Right? Now, what are the two things on which it depends? First, we have learned is the force itself. Or we will say it. More specifically, magnitude of force. Magnitude of force multiplied by the perpendicular distance into the perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation. Now there is a lack of space here, so I'll just make it you have to just follow. So it's a magnitude of force. The product, the moment of force is a product of the magnitude of force and the perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation. Okay. Now if I just rub this and I just say this is the force and this is the maximum displacement, let us say OP, then what will be the moment of force or the torque? The torque will be F into OP, right? Now what will be the units then? The next thing that comes to our mind, that force is the SI unit is Newton, right? And for the distance, the SI unit is meter. So I can say it is Newton meter. So the SI unit for the moment of force or for the torque is Newton meter, right? We can also make a smaller unit for this, that is in CGS system. This Newton will then become dyne, okay? And meter will then become centimeter. So it is dyne centimeter. Now let us see the conversion, how you can convert Newton meter into dyne centimeter. I just rub it once again. So Newton meter. Now Newton is how many dynes? It's 10 to the power 5 dynes. And meter into centimeter, so it is 100 centimeter. So if you are anytime asked, just show the relationship between the Newton meter and dyne centimeter, you can simply write it like this. And the next step, I'll just add this 2 up. So 10 to the power 5 dyne into 10 to the power 2 centimeter. I can write like this. So the powers will be added. So 10 to the power 7 dyne centimeter. Now we know this is for the force and this was for the distance. Now force is a vector quantity, remember, right? And therefore moment of force will also be a vector quantity. If you remember what is vector quantity, that it is having not only the magnitude of force but also direction. Here direction is very important, whether it is moving, the body is moving in an anti-clockwise motion or in a clockwise motion. So there is a certain direction that is coming into the picture, and therefore this is going to be a vector quantity. So please remember, the moment of force is a vector quantity. All right.